not gonna be before you long. I'll ask you to pray for me and at least in a while. But I'm excited about sharing God's word again. Ask that you be praying for our pastor. He's not feeling well. Pray for his healing. I want you to know this great work that's going on here today is not Reverend Mike's vision. It's our pastor's vision, Reverend Lawrence Evans Sr. It is his mission for us is to discipline the church on the inside, to impact the world on the outside. That's what you see going on today. We're just co-laborers, the kitchen, staff. We're just doing our part and serving God. Before we get into the word today, as always, I want to share with you that we're recording these sermons. We like to pass them out, bless others with God's word. We want to ask that you put your cell phones on vibrate. If you get a call, you don't necessarily have to answer it right now. At least be respectful like the young lady did and step out. We want God's word to go forward. We want healing to go on. And this meal that you're getting is just good. But this word is spiritual. And if you take it in, it can save you. So we're going to be free. Our subject today is going to be, there is a way. There is a way. We're going to be speaking from the book of Proverbs, chapter 14, primarily dealing with verses 12 through 16. Our key verse is going to be verse 12. And it reads it. There is a way that seems right to a man, but it ends in the way of death. Give you a little introduction. The Bible often uses contrasts to make things stand out more clearly to us. The book of Proverbs is dominated by the contrast between the wise man and the fool. So when I use the word fool, don't think Brother Mike is calling you a fool because that's not what I'm doing. The word is saying wise man or the fool. Look with me now at one place of contrast in verse 15. It says, the simple believes every word, but the prudent considers well his steps. As we read verse 12 through 16 in this entire, it said, there is a way that seems right to a man, but it ends in the way of death. Even in laughter, the heart may be soft, and the end of merit may be grief. Verse 14 tells us, the backslider in heart will be filled with his own ways, but a good man will be satisfied from above. The simple believes every word, but the pertinent considers well his step. A wise man fears and departs from evil, but a fool wages and is in self-contempt. He's caught up on himself. The simple believes everything. The kitchen is ready to serve, so y'all may go up and get your meal. I want you to enjoy that meal, but please be as quiet as you can so the word can continue to go forward. The simple believes everything. Definition. He is gullible and undiscerning. See, when you just simple-minded, when you're caught up in the world, you just go with everything that's flowing. You believe everything that's out there. I want you to know there's some stuff out there that can set you up, that can trap you, man. We know the devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy. He came to lie to you. He came to steal your grace. The fool goes running after everything that comes along. Any hot deal that jumps off the truck you want to grab. Anybody say they got something good you think is good, you're looking for a quick fix. But I tell you, there is a quick fix. That quick fix is Jesus Christ. That word you can count on. But there are some things out there that seem easy, that seem free, that seem that they're funny. But that way ends in death and destruction. There's grave danger in this. Because there's a way that seems right, but ends in death. It may look right as well as good to you.
Amen. Others walk away. Man, when you're trying to live right, when you're trying to follow God, people want you to think you're going the wrong way. They want you to think that serving God is a boring road, that Christians don't have no fun, that we don't have no joy. But I tell you, that's not so. The world would have you to think that all the pleasures, all the joy, all the fulfillment is in the world. But God's words tell us that following the world, going the wrong way, leads to death and destruction. Because there is a laughter that ends in sorrow. You look at the book of Proverbs 14:13 and say, even in laughter, the heart may sorrow. And the end of merit may be grief. Ecclesiastes 7:2-4 tells us, better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of feasting. For that is the end of all men. And the living will take it to heart. Sorrow is better than laughter. For by a sad countenance, the heart is made better. Sometimes when you're going through some things, that's really when your heart is being healed and you're growing spiritually. Verse 4 tells us, the heart of the wise is the house of the mourner. But the heart of the fool is the house of marriage. See, when you're thinking what you do is going to fix your problems, you're already going the wrong way. Fun on the surface, but misery underneath. Oh, some of these guys you see rolling on these 22s or 24s, whatever they got out there now, pumping that super bass. Look like they got it going on the outside. They don't want you to know they're catching pure hell on the inside. They don't want you to know they're wearing all night. Who's going to knock on the door? When the man's going to come out. But when you follow God and you're trying to live right, you can rest in peace. It may look good. It may look apparent. But if you're doing wrong, wrong is going to catch up with you. That's not what Reverend Mike is saying. That's what the Word is saying. Because there's life that ends in sorrow. Maybe you're doing all right right now, but if you're going contrary to God, it's going to catch up with you. Marriage that ends in heaven. Because the backslider shall be filled with his own way. Proverbs 1:31 tells us, therefore they shall eat the fruit of their own ways and be filled to the full with their own fancy. Meaning, you get so caught up in what you do, you think you got all the answers. Get full of your own word. Sometimes we're so caught up in our wrong, we think we're right. But Proverbs 14:14 tells us, the backslider in heart will be filled with his own ways. But a good man will be satisfied from above. Reverend Mike, I don't have the answers. I cannot fix my problems, let alone your problems. Or your problems, let alone my own problems. I'm dependent on grace. I'm dependent on the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit to show me the way.
Amen.
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 Backslider. Fools. Who is devil? The world will tell you anything, man. Just to suck you in. He ends up getting what he wants on this side. But he loses his way. And we know that death and destruction is on the other side. Find yourself on that downhill spot. It ain't nothing spiritual about going downhill. Well, we know it's hot down there in here. They burning down there. We want to be caught up in the rapture and ascend to above with it. confidence. Start bragging, start thinking you got it right. But that's only temporary, man. Everything on this side is going to be destroyed. Nothing is going to be left but the body of Christ. There's nothing tangible that you're going to have that you can carry with you. Love when the pastor say, he's never seen a hearse with a U-Haul behind it. You can accumulate all kind of wealth, but you can't take it with you. Everything on this side is going to be destroyed. What we're concerned about is where we're going to spend our eternity. Where is our spirit going to go? The fool runs after whatever goes by and gets in big trouble because of the dangers that lurks from them. There is trouble out there around that corner. But the cute man looks well to his goal. The definition of the wise. The book of Job, chapter 28, verse 28 tells us, and to man he said, behold the fear of the Lord. That is wisdom. See, to fear the Lord is wisdom. And to depart from evil is understanding. When you start easing towards righteousness and start accepting God's word, you're going to move away from evil things. You're not going to let it trap you. Don't get me wrong. I got some family. I love them. Don't always love them. Try to spend quality time with them. But when they start doing things that's contrary to my belief in serving God, Brother Mike got to step away. See you later, Brother Reba Nurture. Catch you when you come back on this side. That don't mean I don't love them. That means I ain't going to be out there doing any and everything, risking my salvation, risking this great gift, risking all that Jesus suffered for. Definition of the wise man. He studies before he follows. You ain't gonna be able to tell a wise man just anything. Everything sounds good to you, ain't good for you. Ain't meant for you. But the world won't make it sound good. They're gonna make it temporary. Man. He tries to see the end before the beginning. Oh man, you gotta look at it. Is it worth your salvation? Is it worth giving up the greatest gift that man can receive, and that is salvation through believing in Jesus? He looks at those already on the way. You want to learn how to look at righteous, you look at somebody who's trying to live righteous. That don't mean they got it all right. That don't mean we don't make no mistakes. But you see us getting up day after day, pushing past the physical and living in the spiritual. Putting aside our needs and coming into God's house to service you and help you meet your needs. Help to meet you where you stand. Let you know the Lord loves you just the way you are. He might not like some of the things you're doing, but he still loves you. He's providing for you. Sharing with the brothers a few minutes ago. What else in this town? In fact, anywhere else, you're going to get some homemade cornbread. Homemade. That ain't different now. Get your staff there early this morning, mixing that cornbread and praying over that cornbread. Baked chicken. Them ain't TV dinners. That's baked fresh chicken. That chicken been prayed over. That chicken been anointed over. That's God's grace. And I pray that you understand that. That's not a normal thing going on. That's him trying to show you some faith. But even in all that, that meal cannot save you. If you think getting the meal in here was your gift today, you got it dead wrong. The meal is just part of the blessing. What can really save you is God's word. They can fill you in a way you will never hunger again. Amen. I preach to myself. Because I believe this word of God. Amen. He is satisfied from within. Himself, that's a wise man. It says again, but a good man will be satisfied from above. Going back to part A, it says the backslider in heart will be filled from his own way. See, you can't be filled. your own way and be alive. You gotta know you don't have the answer. The answers are found in the King James Version of the Holy Bible. God has left solid direction for us to follow through the word that he sent down to the apostles to be documented. He does not depend on external. I'm not dependent on the world to save me. I'm not dependent on anything that God can do to save me. I'm dependent on the Holy Spirit, knowing that Jesus died for me, knowing that I've been watched, knowing that if I stay faithful, if I believe in him, I have a Savior. I have a bridge over troubled water. I have a lawyer in the courtroom. They call him Wonderful, Prince of Peace.
That comes with peace right there.
But do you believe that he can save? He knows what evil will do. And he keeps away from it. We made it plain that the devil comes but to kill, steal, and destroy. He gonna make it sound good. He gonna wrap it up in a nice package. Oh man, I still like a little R&B. I share with y'all every now and then. I used to be an old DJ. So I'm not going to be up here and be no opponents. I don't ever listen to blues. I don't like R&B. I like the music. Me and my wife, by the time they're going up, we're going to go on a date tonight or tomorrow night. Or sometimes we can celebrate Valentine's. So I'm not going to sit here and say I don't listen to music. Because I do. I'm not going to be a hypocrite. Old Johnny Taylor had a song out called Doing Your Own Thing. Doing your own thing. One of the verses in the song was saying about stay up all night and drink beer all day. Now I don't throw no beer cans in your backyard. What do you have to say? Doing my own thing. That's all I want to do. This is what Johnny Taylor was saying in the Psalms. But Proverbs make it plain. There's a way that seems right to a man, but it ends in death. That's what doing your own thing would do. As we get ready to close. There are two kinds of people, the foolish and the wise. Again, this is not Brother Mike, this is the word. They do two kinds of things. They run out of whatever goes by. Or they weigh carefully where they go. That's the decision you have. There are two ways to go. The way that seems right. Let me tell you, in the book of John 14, 5 through 6, Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. And how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So we made it plain. There is a right way. And that's through Jesus. If you go any other way than God, the end is death. The mirror is sorrow. Maybe laughing on this side, but you're going to be crying on the other side. The reward is great if you follow Jesus. But the attitude of arrogance, self-indulgence, self-pleasing, is destruction. I want you to know there's no other way than Jesus. Because we know that he came down, he humbled himself a little lower than the angels, but for a little while. Take on the body of man. He didn't have to do it, but he did it for you and I. The world was so corrupt, we were going in such a bad way that God was trying to decide what he was going to do to us. Was he going to wipe us out again? Was he had stopped speaking to us. So at a time where man was doing his best, his worst, excuse me, where man was doing his worst,
ain't no way in.
God decided to do his best. He sent Jesus down through a Virgin Mary. We know that he had an earthly ministry. He taught.
Yep.
He healed the blind, the lame walked. He rose Lazarus from the dead. All manners of power. So he didn't have to go that way. He did it so we would know.
Didn't go too.
Even with all of that.
They
brought him a full power. Not the Romans, the Jews, his own people, God's chosen people. They wanted him charged with something, but Pilate said, I can find no wrong in this man. What had Jesus done? What lie had he told? What crime had he committed? Even though he had committed none, they wanted him dead. They was ready to stone him, man, but his time hadn't came. As he shared the scripture to his fulfillment with him. Later on, they led him to Calvary. They made him bear his own cross. Kicking on him, spitting on him, beating on him. They tortured him, man. They thought they had it going on. Even now on the cross, three crosses, two thieves and Jesus. One dying because of sin, one dying in sin, and one dying for sin, and that one dying for sin was Jesus. He had committed no sin. He was dying for their sin, he was dying for your sin, and he was dying for my sin. One was still caught up on the devil. And if you be who they say you are, come down off that cross and save yourself and then save us. But one was caught up on the spiritual. He said, this man, Jesus, has done nothing wrong. But we're guilty. And he looked at Jesus. He said, when you come into your kingdom, remember me. Right there in the dying hour, Jesus told that thief, today you will be with me in paradise. That thief, while hanging on the cross, had found the right way. That it wasn't his way. It was trusting Jesus. And he died on the cross. They didn't take his life. He gave up his life for you and I. But he didn't stay there. Even after they buried him, they thought it was all over. Here the Romans are. The Jews, his own people, they're so smart. Pharisees and Sadducees, they wanted him dead, man, so they could celebrate the Passover. But how are you going to celebrate the Passover without the Lamb? How are you going to celebrate the Passover without the firstborn? How are you going to celebrate the Passover without Jesus? Be like trying to have chicken and dressing with no chicken. It ain't going to work. Even in the world today, we got some folks that are so heavenly bound and they ain't no work to do. They think their way is the right way. They don't learn a few scriptures. They come to the church on Wednesday and Sunday. But on Monday, they cussing and lying. So their way is not the right way. There is but one way. And that way is Jesus. We know that he rose on the third day with all power. So I tried to make it plain. If you've never accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, but today Reverend Mike has made it plain, and you want to stop going in your own way, and you want to start trusting in Jesus, today could be your day. You would have one that's never accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior. But through the word today, it's been made plain. And you want to get off your boat and get on this Christ heaven-bound boat. All you got to do is raise your hand. I see you, sister. Maybe you believe in it. But you're willing to be honest, and I know this sister already saved, so this is her part right here. But you found yourself getting caught up in a way that seemed right to you, even though you believe. But you're ready to repent or ask for prayer and get back in fellowship with the Father. This is your moment. Now it's time to raise your hand, sister. Do you want prayer? Do you want to rededicate? Amen. Let's give our hand. Let's give our hand. Amen. The Bible tells us, there are more rejoicing in heaven over one repentant sinner than a multitude of the righteous. The heavens are rejoicing, sister. This is real. And it only works for those who believe it is real. disgraceful. But those of us who believe in Jesus, we know that there is power in prayer. That's why today the First Lady asked to pray for the pastor. She knows there is power in prayer. She knows that prayer changes things. That's why the sister rededicated. She's learned through the word that if you repent and admit that you've been going the wrong way, but right now you want to turn and go the right way, that you are washed. Do we have anybody else in here that won't pray? We don't even know your business. Amen. Let's give our hand. That too. Good man. Come on now. Don't be selfish. It don't have to be a crowd in here to celebrate Jesus. That's being bold. It don't take but one or two. Three have asked for prayer. First lady have asked to pray for the pastor. So we're going to be obedient. Wonderful day today. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. Thank you for being God all by yourself. Thank you for your most precious gift, Jesus Christ, and the blood that was shed on Calvary. As the First Lady has requested, we were praying for our pastor, Reverend Lon Circle Sr., praying for healing, praying that his health be restored. Not our will, Father, but your will. We know because he has taught us that there's nothing that you can't do. And we know, Father, that he's in your hand. Because there's this work that's going on here. It's this vision that you have sent him down from heaven. This work you have commissioned him to do. Because of that work, three have repented today. Three have been restored back to the Father. We're praying today, Lord, that they know that it's real. When you raise your hand, your heart was burning. When you raise your hand, he acknowledged you. It was wrote in the book of life. This ain't no joke. The world will have you thinking it is, but this is business. This is God's business. And he in the saving business. He's not in the feeding business. The feeding is something we do to show you how much he loves you. The gift is when you rededicate and accept him as Lord and Savior. And three, accepted and rededicated. So Lord, we thank you that the word went forward. We thank you that the word was received. We are already calling it victory. We know because at the cross, victory was won. The devil lost. Because he thought he had got rid of Jesus, not knowing that the scripture was being fulfilled. So we thank you, Lord. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for our pastor and First Lady. We thank you for Reverend Doug, Reverend Ed, myself, the staff, the body of Christ. And we thank you for these walk-ins that are receiving God's word. These are all blessings, most humbly pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's give God a big hand like the room is full. Like we're rid of me. Amen. May God hold you. May God bless you. May God keep you. God bless you. Amen. Now, since this y'all was so big, I got some DVDs up here today. And I usually don't give out the gospel mixes. I'll start giving them out. I just give out the sermons. But I got some good gospel videos today. And anybody that come up here will bless you. So feel free to come up and ask me for some DVDs. I got three or four different ones I'm willing to share today. Just give me a minute to start some music, and I'm going to pass them out. Amen. Let's give God a hand one more time. Amen.
You got to see it too. right, election of faith, that's what I'm saying.
Come next week, or he could even come.